Hey YouTube, Dawson Ryder here. Welcome to my review for Power Rangers Beast Morphers Season 2 Episode 8, Boxed In. So this was an interesting episode. It was the debut of the Beast X King Ultrazord formation, which is the Ultrazord formation using the Beast X King instead of Red Racer in its place. And we also got a Mighty Morphin Easter egg in the form of the Pan Global Games, which is something that was introduced in that series or shown in that series. And so that's come to town. And that's kind of one of the centerpieces of this episode, because like the main plot is the Rangers want to go see the Pan Global Games, but they have to go check out all the Morphex towers and do maintenance on them, and for whatever reason, Ravi's being a douche about it. And when they're doing that, all of a sudden, there's all these attacks that start happening. And I think that was the best thing about the episode, is it felt like the Rangers' backs were to the, or they were on the ropes. Get it? Because boxing? I kind of liked that about this episode, is that it felt like there was constant attacks, so it was like a smart strategy on the villain's part, because they did this weird system where they're like, well, we don't need all of us to check the Morphex towers, right? And I was like, why aren't the regular employees just doing this? I don't know why they're sending the Rangers to do this. That didn't make sense to me, other than the fact that they needed it for this episode. I mean, obviously the Rangers are supposed to guard them, like they said, but I felt like for checking them, it would have made more sense to have just regular employees do it, especially since they're not really officially employees, since they made that clear with Devin. I don't know. That I thought was kind of stupid. But anyway, they come up with like this basically drawing, you know, the short stick system so that Ravi and Steel, there we go, can go watch the games while the other three check the maintenance. And then they're attacked first, and they get overwhelmed, so they have to call in Ravi and Steel, who reluctantly show up and help save the day. And Ravi's pretty mad. He's like, how hard did you guys really try? It's like, after all, there used to be three of us. What would you have done if they never debuted the other two? Although I guess Nate would have been one of those. But it just kind of reminded me of that, when like, after the Sixth Ranger debuts, it's all of a sudden a situation where the other five Rangers can't handle something without a Sixth Ranger. I'm like, what would you have done if the Sixth Ranger never debuted? You'd be fine. You got plenty of numbers to handle this. But anyway, so he's really upset about that. Because he wanted to watch the games. Like, if only there was some sort of way that you could watch something like that online later, after they were over. I think it's called, wait, online. And then after that, though, Gigadrone's attacking, and Red Racer Zord goes to fight it, and it gets trapped in, like, this boxing arena building that Blaze and Roxy set up, because they're trying to do something helpful while Evox is away, being Mayor Daniels at this event. And it's really funny because there's a moment where like these attacks were happening and like Red Racer Zord and Devin get there because he leaves first, but then the other Rangers are stuck in traffic. And I'm like, why does teleporting not exist anymore? There's so many episodes with plot lines like these that could be easily solved by teleporting. Like, I guess I get that it was a Zordon era thing, but I can't imagine that, have they ever not thought about one season bringing it back? Is it seems weird that like, oh man, we're stuck in traffic in 2020, but in 1993, this would have been solved instantly. That's like, now most things don't work. Everything else got better since 1993. Like, why have we devolved the Ranger technology? It's just like, there needs to be like a list of like Ranger problems that could have been solved by teleporting, especially this one. It was like literally traffic and they show them stuck in traffic. But anyway, Devin's fighting him in this boxing ring scenario, and there's like an announcer, and more Gigadrones keep getting popped in. It felt like a very classic PR thing. For some reason, for me, this felt tonally weird. Like, obviously, you could just tell, even if you've never seen the series, that it was Sentai footage, but there was something about it that it just felt weird having a Gigadrone do something over the top like that. There was something tonally weird about it, but it was neat because, like, again, they felt like they were against the ropes because of boxing, and they were throwing a lot at the Red Ranger, and they were trying to figure out how to get in, and they couldn't do it. And then Nate happened to think of, oh, we'll use this new formation. I think I can configure the Beast X King to work as the Ultrazord formation main piece, and that could use enough power to break through this because we can't get through this door. And they do that, so we debut the Beast X King Ultrazord, but then they send other Gigadrones, but then they eventually get Nate out of there. Why is everybody Nate? They eventually get Devin out of there, and it turns out that the boxing arena thing was actually a Gigadrone itself, and they defeat him. And then at the end, you know, I'm like, oh man, we missed pretty much most of the games, and Robbie's upset about it again, but then he apologizes. He's like, you know, golly gee, guys, we should have just all done it together. And then they go finish the work, but then they, you know, manage to make it for the final karate event. So This episode is a little bit mixed for me, because like I said, I really liked the idea of the Rangers sort of having their resources spread thin and the villains having a lot of, like, onslaught of attack between, like, the boxing thing. Red Racer Zord was clearly in, like, a pickle. I don't know why I said that. It sounded like a 1950s dad, but I guess that's the way the show sounds sometimes, like a 1950s dad. And then, you know, with the initial attack, so it felt like the villains were being really proactive and the Rangers were really being challenged, and it made for a really solid episode, and like, I liked the way that the Beast X King debuted, but I don't know why. I mean, in the Pan Global Games was a nice little Easter egg. If they were gonna have something like that, it's cool that they used, you know, a little name like that as a nice Easter egg to show the shared world and stuff like that, and it's not a big deal, it's a nice and subtle thing, but The Ravi plot I didn't like for a couple reasons. One, it felt weird that it was Ravi doing this. It felt completely out of character in my opinion, since he's usually Mr. By the Book, you know, had to break up with my girlfriend because of rules, hid that I'm an artist because of the rules guy, that's all of a sudden acting like a douche about like, man, I wanted to watch people lift weights. Like, I really wanted to people just watch lift stuff. I'm like, God, could there be anything more boring to ditch stuff for? But I just don't get it. It's not relatable to me. But in the beginning, you watch it online later. So it felt weird for it to be Ravi. And then I was thinking about it. I was like, okay, who could they have used instead? Nobody, because you didn't need to do this. This is a classic example of an episode where it's okay, honestly, Power Rangers, I promise it'll be okay, to take 1 week off. You don't gotta teach someone something every time. Like, this would have been a good episode as just an entertaining episode where the villains were really stretching the Rangers' resources thin and they overcame it and we debuted a new Zord. Like, it's okay to not have every episode teach a moral lesson, especially really, like, cheesy. And the lesson in this one was just kind of stupid, too. Like, it was very specific to the Rangers' lesson, you know, or the Rangers' situation. So, I think it'll be okay if you guys don't teach a lesson every week. Also, small note, I think we did get a slightly altered new opening, because they did include a shot of the Beast X King Ultra Zord, or what I thought was, maybe it was going by so fast, was the formation where it was just yellow blues and Beast X King Zords, but there was a shot of that, and I believe a shot of yellow using that new, like, helicoptery blade weapon, unless I was mistaken, but I think we got a slightly altered opening, so I wanted to make note of that. Also of note, we do have apparently another episode next week, so we are getting one more episode than usual before the hiatus, so that is cool. So next week will be our mid-season finale. It's probably not going to behave like a normal mid-season finale, it'll just be like an episode, but you know what I mean. But overall, I would give this episode, I think, a 7. I think it probably was a little bit better than that in some respects, but for me, it was just kind of mixed in the way it was done, but I think it was mostly a solid episode. What did you guys think of the episode, though? Let me know in the comments, and until next time, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and climb the steps and ring that bell so you can get notifications for my videos. Dawson Ryder, signing out.